Hi, we are going to make a new video, but not this time about Arch Linux D, but maybe I'll start my story here, but about Arch Linux B. Every new desktop, and LXQT is for us a new desktop, is started with Arch Linux D scripts. So on the GitHub, we have scripts, and in there, we can decide what to install and use. So the idea is to first start off with a bunch of scripts, and in this case, LXQT uses OpenBox as a session manager backend, right? So we made a copy paste, super easy. Everything is created. 13 desktops now with LXQT, 14 desktops. So we started with a copy paste from OpenBox, right? And then we figured out we don't need this, we don't need that, we don't need it, and we want to add that, we need this, and so on. So we adapt. Like I always said, say it's like a big Lego box and you're choosing your own pieces. What do you want to have as browser? What do you want to have as? But there are very more core applications as well. What does this desktop need? Right, so that's what we've done in Arch Linux D. Next point is whatever we learned that we need to add and do and stuff like that, we need to make a script for Arch Linux B. So build your own ISO, Arch Linux B. Video has not been created yet. But everything is ready. The article is here. This is what you'll end up with. And it only takes 5 minutes to install it, because that's the fun in Arch Linux B. You build your own ISO. You say, I want Firefox. You say, I want Chrome, etc. So you want to change the files in packages x86-64? Do that. If you don't want to change it, also good. But the thing is, you need to run a script. And these days we have script 30 and 31, but just 31 for the guys who want a Linux long-term support kernel. But basically, it's always, every video in here is always the same thing. Download a GitHub, run script 30. Every video in here is same thing. But the end result is Plasma, is OpenBox, is Mate, and so on. So basically, we're doing it over and over again. And let's do it and document everything. So, Control C. Desktop is a nice place to start. Open a new window, right mouse click, open terminal here. Oh, Git clone is already in there. Control Shift V. Right? Git clone me that specific script. You get a folder, and in the folder is some information, maintenance for us, the installation scripts in script, and this is important thing if you want to change your vinyl. Do a quick change to see how easy it is. Don't start changing important stuff, but start changing things to say, I don't like GPIC, never will, won't work for me. GPIC is this thing. It's going to find the color in your system here. And that's for designing. I'm not gonna design ever. So GPIC, just give it a hashtag. And in this video, a hashtag Eric, control save, of course, and GPIC is not installed on the ISO. It was that simple. So a hashtag in front of it, or type your package that you need, but you can only add packages in here from Arch Linux, not from AUR. AUR is later on, after installation, you go and type yay minus S Spotify, right? Things that coming from AUR is later. Then, we go to either this one or that one. That's a new one, very, very recent new one. So the website says 30, but if you want to have an LTS kernel, so you use that one. That's only if you need it, basically if you need it, right? So number 30, and that's it. Now you can have a cup of coffee or tea or a beer, some whiskey. Don't know what time of the day it is, but you have to just wait now. Now, let's talk about tiling. So if I click here, the one is behind it. So with a super 4, I'm gonna tile things. By yourself, if you don't have it, a separate keyboard with a separate numeric keypad, which is so easy. A separate one and not incorporated in your regular keyboard, like small laptops like that. But an external keyboard often has a separate numeric keypad. And then you can focus on a window and say, this thing, I'm gonna super F6 it. Sorry, not F, but 6 it. Or super 9 it. Super 3 it, you see? And normally I'll show you it like this. If I put this like that, I know I'm building something. So that's my reminder, because I'm doing always things on different computers. This shows me, here's the script, here's it running. I have to wait and check out later the ISO in the folder, and the folder will be on your home directory. Let's wait and investigate later. So let's have a look. What have we done? We have here this ISO that has been built. We can close all these things up and go to Eric, the home directory, Control H. We don't need to see the hidden folders and files. We have the Arch Linux B out. There can be an Arch Linux D out and an Arch Linux out. So we're building a B version, and this is the guy we've just built. So now it's up to you, and probably first a VirtualBox thingy, right? Super F7, and then load it up, see if you like it. You'll see JPEG is gone, and don't need to check, I know JPEG is gone. But there you go, that's how you actually create your own personal version of any of our desktops out there, any of our ISOs that we make. All right, have fun.